Greetings from the face of shipping. Today, we're in London, England, and it's the 16th of February, 2011. As you know, we've been discussing piracy in quite some detail, and earlier this month, we captured on film the discussions at the IMO from the Secretary General of the United Nations, Secretary General of the International Maritime Organization, and others about piracy. And part of that program is the humanitarian response. Many of you have met Dr. Peter Swift. He's been very kind in his role as managing director of InterTanko to address you, and you have seen on the last DVD his retirement. He has taken up in a voluntary role now to chairman the humanitarian response to piracy, and he's going to speak to you today along with Dr. Marion Gibson. Dr. Marion Gibson has a tremendous amount of experience, frontline experience dealing with trauma, and her CV will accompany this. So we're very fortunate that we have two very experienced professionals in the marine field and the trauma field to talk about this very important subject. And so I'd like to ask Peter, first, thank you very much for making time to speak to the seafarers
George,
again.
George, always good to be
and
here.
And Dr. Gibson, thank you so much. I'd like to ask Peter if he could start off talking a little bit about the program itself.
Thank you, George, for the introduction, and thank you to everybody for the opportunity to talk to you again today on the important subject of piracy. This is something that has been with us for too many years now and has certainly reached headline proportions over the last few years. All of us, and I am sure that everybody that's seeing this DVD will feel that we would love to put a stop to piracy. So congratulations and appreciation from us to all 1 million that signed the petition earlier, last year now, at the end of last year, that went to the United Nations Secretary General, went to the Secretary General of the International Maritime Organization, calling for a stop to piracy. That's a very clear message. That message has been well received, but unfortunately we're not going to be able to stop it overnight. And it's important that we have in place programs that recognize that. Now, another part of this DVD series, I believe, will include the discussions that took place very recently and the presentations made by the Secretary General of the United Nations, Secretary General of the IMO, and others, when they were talking about this year's theme for the International Maritime Organization, the IMO. They have chosen for their theme this year, Maritime Piracy, IMO Orchestrating the Response. That is the IMO coordinating and orchestrating a program that will address piracy. It's a six-point action program. A lot of that is political. It's asking countries to provide naval support and intervention vessels. A lot of it is directed to countries and to companies, asking them to make sure that the right measures are in place to ensure that ship managers are hardened, are well prepared in the unfortunate and perhaps unlikely event that they are actually attacked. Equally, though, there is a sixth objective in that program, and that is the one that we are addressing specifically. That sixth objective is to talk about care for seafarers, for you and for your families, in the event of an attack or piracy. And we've been very fortunate that we've been able to bring together a wide range of interested parties on this subject. We have our industry colleagues, the ship owners, ship managers, manning agents, and the like. We have our other industry partners who are involved in the commercial aspects of insurance of the business. We have our welfare considerations, our seafarer centres, our health organisations, and other parties that are equally concerned about the subject. And we also have our labour colleagues in this joint industry programme. And our program has a very simple title. It is Maritime Piracy, a Humanitarian Response, because that is the area we're very much focused on, the human aspect, the humanitarian aspect. And we want to address this in a professional manner. We all can say we're concerned for our welfare, your well-being, and that's true. Nobody should doubt that. But equally, we need to have in place a program that addresses it in a professional manner, that we can provide practical guidance, pragmatic guidance, that's put together by those that have a professional understanding of the business. of being subject to trauma, to shock, and to some of the concerns that arise, not only in individuals, but also within families, and then are shared within the family considerations. So within the programme, we're very fortunate that Dr. Marion Gibson, who's with me at the moment, and her colleagues have been participating by organising workshops already and by planning further workshops with a view to give us guidance in terms of being prepared before sailing into an area, during the unfortunate event should one take place, and post-event, post-incident. So Marion, maybe you'd like to say a few words about your part of the programme.
Thank you very much. I welcome this opportunity to put our side of the story, because our side starts and I hope ends with the family and the people you love and the people that are waiting for you when you go home. My experience in trauma has mainly been in land situations, but for the last 12 years I've been helping to put the need for training on trauma response into the seafaring world, and I've been around for about 10 years in this work. When we were asked to come and give some advice and to get involved in this program, I became very aware of the vastness of the parties involved. The chairman has outlined the various people that we have now in partnership. And so I was asked to try and find out what were the needs of the seafarers and their families in this terrible but unlikely incident where a piracy attack takes place. Unfortunately, the statistics can remind us that it isn't going away. And so one of the things I do professionally is listen to people. And so we embarked on a program of listening. Listening to seafarers' wives whose partners and husbands have been taken hostage. Listening to what they needed as in a help and a support with maintaining family life in these extraordinary situations. And also what helped and what didn't help. We then had the opportunity to talk with some released hostages, and their stories taught us a lot. We have taken that and applied professional and psychological theories that we know and adapted it to fit the situation. The title of the program is Humanitarian Support, and we feel that listening is an important beginning point. Today at this meeting, we presented some findings when we got together a consultative group in Hong Kong just before Christmas. These were people from a large range of countries representing the nationalities that you come from. So we listened, we shared experiences, we shared approaches, and there was a lot of changed opinions and a lot of people sticking to opinions. But we came down fundamentally that wherever people are in the industry, there are virtually three things we need to look at. That is, what are the needs before, what are the needs during any incident that involves piracy, and how can we help both the seafarer and their family recover and get back to normality after this very abnormal situation? We've outlined a matrix, a square in which we're putting in the filling in the details. But it's important that we see that things can be done now to make sure that people are aware of what might happen, and in that way ensure less stress if they have to handle this situation. The wives told us they wanted communication with the company, with the manning agents, but they wanted to talk to one person. They didn't want every time they phoned up to talk to another person who maybe didn't know them. A very simple thing would be that there was one liaison person with the authority to speak, to build up a relationship with the family, and to keep them informed of the progress of what's happening in a structured way. A lot of people we spoke to said, well, why are you talking about the children? Now, if you're a father, you'll know. You don't always have to tell children what's happening. They sense it. And so we believe for the welfare of the children that they should get an explanation why mum may be distressed, why she is jumping every time the telephone rings. And so we're thinking of putting into this a line which covers telling children at the level they will understand what's happening. Because they're part of the family, they sense any tension, and it's important that they're looked after. Talking to the seafarers, they said that one of their main anxieties was what was going to happen to their family. Were they still going to be paid? Were the family going to be supported? And so they weren't vastly different when we identified the needs. But what we're saying to the industry with the partnership is established today is, can you help? Can we all do this together? Because the needs are not the responsibility of one of the partners. It's so comprehensive, it's so detailed, that we need everybody to work together to achieve this. That's what you would want for your family, isn't it?